waste reduction manager to environmental services manager. And my husband would have said, or just environmental. So you go to the next slide. This, you know, the typical, what's in your waste stream? You know, if we recycled every single thing that we could in our common single stream recycling, we would be at 53 to 55%. When you add the food waste and the yard waste in there, it would be 80%. So I kind of believe San Francisco when you say there were 40%, because it would be possible. So let's go to the next. Here we are. We kind of plateaued our recycling. I've been with the village for 18 years, and since we went single stream carts in 2004, we tick up a percent every year, but it's pretty steady, about 35% recycling rate on the trash. So how are we going to get, if you were in the morning session and the Planet Green sustainability plan that we're trying to achieve says we're going to reach 50%, well, what do you do? Well, food scraps. So work with Waste Management, that's our contractor, when we were discussing a contract extension. And I said, you know, I'll take it to the board, I love working with you guys, but I got a student in the pocket. He said, well, what more do you think we could do? I said, well, I think we could try a pilot program for composting. And he thought about it, and he really helped write the program. I mean, he got the holler of the partnership in this program, really made it work. So you go to the next one. So we had a number of sponsors in the beginning of the program. We received $10,000, a little over $10,000 from the Cook County Department of Environment that purchased our pails and our bio bags. Waste Management provides the carts. The Delta Institute was working with Cook County, so they did all the reports and writing the flowery, you know, here's what's going on kind of thing. And then Glad Bags read an article that was in the Trib and called me up and said, we want to support this program, so we can send you 500 boxes of bags. I said, okay, freeze it. I'll take that. So those are our program sponsors. You can go to the next. So what we did for the pilot program is, it's kind of echoes what Anne says, to get everybody together. And I read a beautiful quote in a magazine just this past week. It said, change is good, but don't assume your residents think so. So we held three forum discussions in the area. We did a direct mailing to 1,200 households. That was our pilot area. It was 1 yard waste route out of 10. And throughout the course of the pilot program, I asked for testimonials from the residents, so I kept track of those. I did, and that helped me go to the board at the end of the season to expand the program village-wide. So we started with 110 households in the pilot area. And because the food waste was mixed in with the yard waste, we had a 96-gallon tubber. It's kind of hard to measure exactly how much was food scrap, but during the winter, when we weren't collecting yard waste, we collected between 2 and 4 tons a month from those 110 households of food scraps. And the winter went to a bi-weekly collection during the winter months. So you go to the next slide. So here's our community outreach. When we expanded the program, we partnered with local organizations. We have a wonderful monthly newsletter, goes into 27,000 households. That includes multi-unit buildings, which really aren't part of the program, but they get the mailing anyway. So we did an insert in the newsletter, and we get a lot of support from the local press. We have our own TV station, so we really do blanket green team school newsletters. We really get the word out. This is our mailer. And information about the program and this little punch-out postcard so they can respond to sign up for the program. Because they have to agree to pay $14 extra. This is not subsidized in any way. I don't personally care for subsidized programs because I think you can put a program in where it's free or at a low cost to residents, and then the next year when the full cost comes due, the program will fail. So I believe in pass along the cost. So that's what we did. And I have a couple slides to show you the box of bio bags. We have a couple of vendors in town where they can purchase bags. But we have a lot of people that don't use bags, or they'll use paper bags, or they'll wrap it in newspaper. It's a weekly collection. They don't have to purchase yard waste stickers. And we're still talking about the elementary collections. So it's a voluntary subscription program. The yard waste stickers, if you were to get a craft yard waste bag, you have to pay for the bag. And then the sticker is $2.36. So that $14 a month is about equal to one yard waste sticker bag a week. Plus, you can downsize your garbage can one size and save another $3.25. We also, the monthly email, which was a wonderful, lovely idea during the pilot program. It was really great. I kept in really good contact with those participants. They helped me with the testimonials to get it expanded throughout the village. I got a lot of good questions and answers going. Now, since we expanded the program, I'm up to 500 households. You can imagine when I send out 500 emails, how many I get back. So it's become a really huge administration program. So that's it. And another thing, the water billing department is going to kill me because we've invited people to share cards and share the costs. And people who were paying $20 a month for their garbage service and are sharing a compost cart with a neighbor, one kept the garbage can. One got rid of their garbage can with a compost can there, and they're saving about $4.50 over what they were paying for just garbage. So that's pretty interesting. So here's some slides on the cost. $21.38 for the 96-gallon garbage service that includes recycling. Plus, if you were to purchase a yard waste sticker every week, it would be about $34. But if you take the garbage service and add the composting cart, it's about $35. But if you share it, $17.69 a month if you share the whole service. And the next slide shows the same kind of equation for someone with a 64-year-old cart. So I've gotten some really good questions when I was doing the forums for the pilot programs. All right, where does our compost go? It's going to Land and Lights on the south side of Chicago, which was purchased last year by Waste Management. So it's nice that our hauler owns the composting facility too. We're pretty lucky. Go to the next slide. So what happens to the composting, people wanted to know? What about backyard composting? And like Mary said this morning, we encourage backyard composting. And we do have a lot of residents that do backyard composting. About 5-6 years ago, we changed our ordinances to allow vegetative food scraps in backyard compost bins. Again, echoing Danny, health department on board all along because they get nervous when you start talking about changing things, trash. So the people who initially signed up, those are the people that want to do the most. They'll pay extra. They want to be the greenest that they can be. And they got a backyard compost. They already had the smallest garbage can. I was wondering, why the heck are they paying me $14 a month to do this? Because there was a teaching opportunity for their children. And because the collection program takes things they can't put in their backyard. It'll take the used napkins and paper towels, the pizza box, the birthday cake plate, all of those things that they can't recycle. But now they can go in their compost bin. So can we get compost? They wanted some of this compost back. So I'll show you a picture in a minute. And another interesting question, do we have to add a truck? They didn't want to add a truck. And are there other benefits to the program? Well, the benefits are that it's not going to the landfill, although the cost is about the same. It costs $47 a ton to bury your trash in the landfill. It costs $44 a ton to take it to composting. But the garbage is going 100 miles south, and the compost is going 20 miles south. So there are some environmental benefits that you could measure. Okay, they wanted compost, I got compost. I made a little deal with the park district, so for a couple months, I could use a corner of their parking lot. I pull in, this year we went through 30 yards of compost that I just dumped in, and the title of that email is, bring your bags and shovels, come and take compost. This is hugely popular. I don't get it, but there it is. And I'm still operating under the 20-60-20 rule. I don't know if you've ever heard this. It's kind of talked about here and there. Is 20% of the people are going to do the best, the most, whatever they can do, even if it costs extra. 60% of the people will do it eventually with enough education and with some cost efficiency built in. And 20% are never going to do it if you went to their kitchen and scraped their plates. So right now we're at 500 households. We have 5 elementary schools, two of those schools that are already zero waste schools, and they have the green teams, they have the little kids in the vests helping the sort line. They have diverted 98% of their original waste with recycling and food scrap composting. Now farmers market, we have organics carts at farmers market and behind the food pantry. So whatever they don't give away, they get rid of it. We also have special events that are now asking for this. We have the microbrew 7 generations head. They've been doing it for about 6 years. They almost did have a zero waste sorting system, but now they can more easily have it collected through the village program. In River Forest, they do a fundraiser every fall. They had 1,400 attendees, raised $20,000, and diverted over 77% of their waste. The Hatch Harvest Dinner, that's at one of our schools, the Hatch School. They had 400 attendees, and they had one bag. And the woman who called me, because I asked her how did it go, because we gave her bids and everything before the school started. And she said, it was great. She said, I was on top of everything with the potluck and telling everybody what they needed to bring. She said, and one mother didn't get the message and brought a bowl of gazpacho with little cups that couldn't be recycled or composted. So that was the one thing that went to the landfill. And then the freight light right run, things like that. They're calling now and asking, hey, we want to do more. We want to be green. So the ongoing promotion, like I said, the monthly emails, the free compost, sign up a neighbor, kind of a thing. I've got a contest going with the schools now. The schools that sign up the most participants are going to get a heritage oak tree planted in the fall. So we're working with the schools. I put the car handle hangers in red. That's what this is. A waste of time and money. So we went through to our pilot program and hung 500 car hangers for people to promote the composting program. We went to the homes that didn't have the organics carts, and I got one person signed up. So, you know, so we figured we're not going to litter the neighborhood with those anymore. Go ahead. So now, the next steps are outreach to grocery stores and restaurants, because the participants are, I found it is true behavior change for many of these people. I've had people email me that they never realized how much food they were throwing away until they had sorted. So they've changed the way they shop. They've changed the way they feed their children. They're calling me that they went to the Buzz Cafe and got a piece of styrofoam to take out. They're very upset by all this. So we're going to continue the efforts throughout the community. So working in restaurants and grocery stores, we have bags that we can give them, reusable bags, and with a flyer that talks about recycling and or composting. So this could go into any restaurant if they have recyclable takeout containers or compostable takeout containers. They can help. They can put these on their counter, they can stick them in the bag, they can put them in their check, you know, presenters. So that is one of the next steps. And working with 7 generations ahead for the large generators, the hospitals, I believe that waste management science happened with the residents.